Last episode, I installed my Parker check valves, and I got a ton of the same two questions. Ton of comments. One guy said he cringed the entire episode watching me assemble my pumps with channel locks.
What?
What are you, some kind of tool noob? That's my $180 pair of Matco plier wrench.
Look
at this thing. Uniform grip. What are you, an idiot? You act like I'm working on your car and you're watching me and you can't stand to watch. On your car, I will use the channel locks. I'll charge you triple for watching. The other question I keep getting is, Parker, I barely know her.
Right now?
Amplifier is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds.
So far, the Parker check valves have been awesome. I'm waiting on some dump seals to replace all the seals for the dumps. Then the hydraulics should be perfect. So for now, I'm going to continue work on the stroker subwoofer enclosure. Stroker? I barely...
Doug, right now...
Stroker, I just porked her.
You shut your fucking whore mouth.
This masterfully designed subwoofer enclosure can either be sealed or ported because of its masterful design. Looks like an alien beam down technology. Alien technology. And a robot made it. The only problem is sealed. This box only has an internal volume of 1.3 cubic feet, which is too small for the ideal ported box for a 12-inch Cerwin Vega stroker. So now what, you may ask? I don't know. I can't make the box any bigger. We're maxed out. Our room has been... We took up the room. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna continue assembling the box as a sealed box. We'll dig up the woofer parameters for a 12-inch stroker, run it through WinISD, simulate the output, and see what we got. If it sounds like shit, we'll have to put the Focal 33KX in there and put the stroker in the F-150 box. We're just gonna have to do what we have to do. But if it sounds good, I'll say I told you so. It's gonna sound fine. I think it might be good.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
What if it sounds like shit?
Right now, it's not...
Right now I'm going to continue cutting sealed layers and I'll save the ported layers just in case I need to rebuild another $4,000 T-Bird box for you, for your T-Bird.
$5,000.
What if it sounds like shit? Six.
Right now, it's not time for this. Right now, it's...
What are you, stupid? I paid $180 for this Matco Nipex plier wrench that you can get on Amazon for probably $50. I left a link in the description. I make affiliate money. Just buy it. Quit being a tool noob. This is better than wrenches because wrenches actually don't fit the fittings perfectly, so they end up marking the fittings. This, you can get a nice tight clamp. As you grip it, it tightens. So as you loosen.
Doug, right now it's not time for this. Right now it's not.
Once the new layers are cut and cleaned up with a flush trim bit, I'll round over the inner edges with one of my Mobile Solutions router bits to create an inner ribbed design, which will chop up any standing bass waves and enhance the bass function. It's gonna make it louder. This box also features an inner stiffening penis, which once constructed, creates a cross brace. Integrated cross brace. For your face. A penis brace for your face. This is where some of you may worry that the router will jump and I'm gonna cut my thumbs off. I can't even open a box without razor blading my wrists open. How am I gonna? Some of you may worry I'm gonna grind my hands to hamburger meat. Handburger. That's because you're a pussy and you watch too many car audio fab kitchen videos. And then it happened. The router jumped. And I trimmed my fingernails. It trimmed them. Look how good they look.
Right now, it's not time for this.
And then I was talking shit and the router jumped and my arm's gone.
It's not the time for this.
I should have used my push block. Look at all those goddamn layers. Son of a fat bitch. Shit! Look how good they look. What if it sounds like shit? What if a 12-inch stroker won't work in this sealed box? Everyone's gonna laugh at me. I'm gonna look like an idiot on YouTube. For the first time in my... look stupid. I'm gonna look dumb. But what if it works? Now I need to start assembling this thing. We gotta do this right, because if we just assemble this thing sealed with glue and nails with a 12-inch Cerwin Vega stroker sealed, it's gonna blow apart like a fucking accordion in my trunk. It's gonna look like a butt-fucked accordion. An accordion is someone who only drives Honda Accords. Have you ever rear-ended an accordion? By rear-ended, I mean butt-fucked. Butt-fucked an accordion? I'm going to use a combination of 1¼-inch screws and 2-inch screws, and I'll stagger them as I assemble it and use the T-square to help me keep the box square so it doesn't end up twisting as I put it together, looking like a stack of twisted Post-it notes. Remember the Post-it notes? Twist? Looks like a spiral accordion. Have you ever fucked a spiral accordion? This looks perfect so far, but this is gonna take a fucking year. So we have plenty of time to look at the woofer parameters sometime in the next 6 months. We can just figure it out later if the woofer's gonna sound good. Huh? How about the...
Oh, look at this.
First Soundman hoodie. Finally here.
Somebody come and look at this. Look at this.
This is a snapback. This has been out. We also got some kid sizes. Girls, pink. A black one. For your little ones. And then there's a baby one in here somewhere. We finally started getting the new merch and it looks really good. Thank you all who ordered so far. We have the new hoodies in stock, shipping now, new kids sizes. We finally have Soundman shop t-shirts with the logo on the front and the logo on the back. We have the flat bill hats and snapback hats and the amplified shirts and the hoodie, all shipping at the same time. For the first time in my life, I did it.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
And I'm only 39. I did it, Mom. I came out with a fucking shirt, finally. Fuck!
Oh.
Oh, go figure, oh. Look at that. Oh, look at that.
How sexual this looks. Damn! The warmth is astounding. It's a miracle. Made in America, I think. Might be Chinese. I don't fucking know, really.
Hoodie's probably made in China, but it's printed on American soil. I'm super excited about the new merch. The t-shirts are really good quality. They're all soft style shirts. They don't shrink funny. The logos stay nice after you wash them. I'm really excited. I can't wait for you guys to check them out. Get one at soundman.co. All your merch purchases go towards the healing of my American Express card. The proceeds, it's an all profit charity for the healing of my personal fucked up credit. From hydraulic parts of drug purchasing. I'm overtaken by... My card's been overtaken.
No! Are you serious? Give me my baby.
That's what I used to drink when I was a baby.
That's the problem. That's the problem we're having.
Look what I found. Parameters. I don't know if these are the right parameters. This looks like the correct manual for the old stroker. I think this has parameters. Yeah, here we go. We'll run these through WinISD Pro and compare a sealed box with a ported box next time and maybe see what this looks like if we were to put it in a bandpass, sixth order, hypothetically. Thank you guys so much for always coming back. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. Buy some new merch at soundman.co. Your support is truly appreciated. Thank you guys so much. Come back for new episodes every Monday and Thursday at 7 a.m. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you could put together for your budget at ctsounds.com.